Even under the searing desert heat, a car and its complete electronic system must work reliably, as well as at the lowest temperatures in ice and snow. But the manufacturers can't always send their products to the desert for testing. That would be too expensive. That's where Lena Maria Schaefer comes in. The 23-year-old doesn't just test her navigation system on the way to work.
With a current temperature of 7 degrees, the satellite navigation system works fine. But to ensure that it works under different temperature conditions, e.g. in extreme heat or cold, we produce climate test chambers to prove this.
Lena Maria works as a technical illustrator for Weiss Umwelttechnik that manufactures environmental simulation systems. In the climate test chambers, almost any temperature and humidity can be created, summer or winter, at the touch of a button. And in this chamber, there's also an electronic assistant.
This is our robot arm. A sensor is placed here at the front, and it presses the navigation system display just like a human finger while measuring the pressure, even at extreme temperatures from minus 40 to plus 80 degrees.
Does the navigation system work in extreme heat or cold? And how great must the pressure be for the touchscreen to react? Even with a second model, these issues need to be clarified. The robot arm is the innovation of the climate chamber. Previously, people had to operate the sat-nav by hand. Now the machine objectively measures each touch of a button and stores the data. As a technical illustrator, Lena Maria develops the climate test chambers on the computer. Before a model goes into production, it must be designed on screen.
This is our CAD program. With this, we construct the complete unit in 3D. We then give the individual specifications, sheet metal design, to our production.
The robot arm is in a protective covering. This is filled with compressed air and protects the high-tech device from the extreme conditions in the climate chamber. Without the covering, all the technology comes to light. Under normal conditions, the test would look like this. But back to our test of the navigation system. Did the two sat-navs perform well? Can they still reliably show the way in excessive heat or cold?
The tests have been successfully completed. It has been proved that both units work well under extreme conditions. With the measurement results, the customer can now make further improvements.
The manufacturers can be pleased. Thanks to the climate chamber with the integrated robot, they now know for sure that their sat-navs don't just work here, but all over the world.